Hi, I'm Stephen Bauer. I am a junior computer science major, and I am an alumni of the Scholars Science Discovery in the Universe program.
Hi, I'm Jonah Chazen. I'm a junior computer science and graphic design major, and I graduated the Design Cultures and Creativity Honors program.
Hello, I'm Siddy Thule. I go by Siddy for short. I'm a junior career science major, and I'm also a graduate of the DC Honors program.
I'm Robert Atkins, computer science and math double major, junior, and I also graduated from the Design Cultures and Creativity Honors program. Usually, HackMIT is a random lottery entrance. You'll apply and you'll just hope to get in based off of chance. But there is the case where if you're one of the first 50 to solve a puzzle that HackMIT puts out, and even finding the puzzle is a puzzle in itself, if you're one of the first 50 to solve it, then you get guaranteed admission for yourself and your team. And this year I was actually the third person to solve that puzzle and get entrance for all of us.
So we were talking about doing that and like the feasibility of it, and then like in the car ride up to the airport we were talking about, like this has a very specific purpose, but wouldn't it be cool if we could develop an, like something that was an extension to an operating system such that like your whole like using a computer experience would be like just natively supported.
Yeah.
So that's how Jonah kind of came up with what ultimately resulted in our final project.
Yeah, it was essentially like we were kind of like thinking a lot of our previous hackathon projects have been like a little out there, and we were like, we should do something a little less out there. We made like a floating chatbot head at Bitcamp last year that would just like say Shakespeare, like mangled Shakespeare to you.
I think you also had, what was it?
We made it, Bitcamp, that was Bitcamp 2 years ago, Bitcamp last year, we made a thing where you take a dollar bill and go like this and it makes accordion noises.
Yeah.
So we were like, okay, what actually wins hackathons? So at first we were like, okay, we could just like ask all the sponsors. But we were like, we should come up with a backup idea in case that doesn't happen. So I was like, it's got to be something that, like, everyone's like, whoa, how'd you do that? But it's actually, like, not that hard to do. So I was thinking, like, so we were actually, like, sitting in the MIT, like, student center lobby, and I was, like, thinking of that idea. Like, thinking of something that would answer that question. I was like, okay, this is actually a really hard thing to think of. And then I, like, thought of something. I was like, oh, okay. So, and then I was like, what if we just... At first I was like, what if we just we could control two computers in the same mouse? Like, you could just move your mouse onto someone else's screen and control it. And then we were like, and then we started thinking about technically what you need to do that, and we realized that a lot of the same software stack could allow you to also just, like, send data over. And so we're like, what if you could send, just, like, what happens if you drag a window to the edge? What if the window went over also? So that was our original idea. We were originally thinking of making it as a Chrome extension, so you could just drag only Chrome windows across. And like, but wouldn't it be cool if it worked for everything? And then we ended up finishing everything but the Chrome part of it.
In regards to hackathons, even the people who don't win prizes, however, do make cool things. So I have a little story about this from HackMIT. So when I would walk to the bathroom, I had to leave the whole area, I would walk by this one group, and the first time I saw them have big pictures of horses on their computer screens. They also had like a whole desktop there, essentially. Come back, and now I see 3D models of these horses. I thought, well, okay, that's a little weird. And I pass by again, now it's a cow the next time. Come back, 3D model of a cow. Keep going back and forth, like I see a sheep, bulls, and so on and so forth. We just keep going with this, and I'm really intrigued to see what they had at the end. And what they had at the end was a VR coloring book where you just drop in 3D models. However, I dubbed them Horse Team because that's what I first saw them as. And they didn't win a single prize, but I thought that was a really interesting project because, like, we beat a robot that read books. That was the runner-up. We beat that. Even in the top 10 or even below that, there's always something cool there. So, you know, I want to, like, encourage anybody, like, even if you think you can't win, you can do something cool. So, maybe go to a hackathon.
Yeah, hackathons aren't just about winning prizes. It's really just how much can you learn in one time period. So, I think just getting as much information about things that you find interesting and then looking into ways to implement those ideas are like totally, you can't get that experience anywhere else aside from when you and a couple of your friends are just working on the same project for 24 hours.